Soon the bird goes out of sight. Nothing showed on the surface of the water except some weed and the purple bladder of the Portuguese man of war floating close beside the boat. The old man saw that the bird was circling again. Obviously, the bird had again spotted some fish. As the old man watched, a small tuna rose in the air and again dropped into the water. Then another tuna likewise rose and fell into the water. One of these fish got hooked by one of Santiago's lines. Santiago pulled it aboard and felt happy. The fish was an albacore, about 10 pounds in weight. Santiago thought that this albacore would make an excellent bait. The sun was hot now, and Santiago felt himself perspiring. It was the 85th day, and the old man wanted to catch a really big fish. Just then, watching his lines, he saw one of the projecting sticks dip sharply. The old man reached out for the line and held it softly in his right hand. He could judge that 100 fathoms down a marlin was eating the sardines, which covered the hook. Since it was the month of September, the marlin must be a huge one. Santiago felt happy that a marlin, that is a big marlin, was nibbling at the sardines which covered the hook. A few moments later, however, it seemed that the marlin had moved away from the sardines. Santiago wondered if the marlin had gone away altogether. Then he felt the gentle pulling touch on the line again, and he was happy that the marlin had not gone away after all. Santiago now felt like a heavy pull up on the line. Obviously, the marlin had got hooked. Santiago let the line slip down, unrolling off the first of the two reserve coil. As it went down, slipping lightly through his fingers, he could still feel the great weight. Santiago had 340 fathom coils of line in reserve, besides the coil he was using. He was inwardly wishing that the marlin would eat the sardine to the point of the hook going into its heart, and in the process it would be killed. But of course, that did not happen. The fish moved away slowly, and the boat began to move also. This meant that the boat was being pulled by the fish. Thus, the fish moved steadily, dragging the boat behind it, towards the northwest. The other boats were still in the water. And now, the old man said aloud, quote, "I wish I had the boy. I am being towed by a fish, and I am the towing bit. I could make the line fast, but then he could break it. I must help him all I can and give him line when he must have it. Thank God he is traveling and not going down," unquote. If the fish were to go down, the old man would be in serious trouble, though he had the confidence that he would be able to think of some device to pull himself out of the difficulty.